YouTube today at powerjackrepair.org. We got Lenovo ThinkPad, should be H15, E450, E550, E555, E560. And those are the most specific. I just can't find the specific model, but they all pretty much the same thing. 20DF-00ED US. US, yeah. Made in Slovakia. Well, the corporate inversion happened to Slovakia from United States, but should be made in China right there. You know what else is made in Slovakia? The most reliable car on the planet, called Porsche Cayenne. So anyways, so you know where it's made and you know how reliable it is. The reason it's here, it's for the power jack repair right there. You see how the center plastic piece broke off and you could see pins. What I will try to do, the thing is that second connector, the second port, the one that's right here, I know I'm not going to be making it work because it's possible to fix it, but not for the fixed prices that we advertise. I mean, I'm going to make the laptop work, but I'm not going to be able to do anything about the docking port. It will take me 3 or 4 times longer to fix that docking port, and for the fixed prices, that's not happening. So the reason I show you those videos is if you want, you could send us just the motherboard, it's going to be cheaper. Alrighty, so most of the screws are the same. Okay, looks good to me. Let's remove this guy right here. Doesn't want to get picked up. All right, so remove that. Let's see, remove that. Let's add a little bit more light. Like that. And here we got more screws. The reason I bent the screwdriver so you could see where I'm putting it in. Alrighty. By the way, the parts you're probably gonna sell on the website below, the link should be below, everything that we use here. Solder, desoldering stations, soldering irons, whatever, screwdrivers, everything is at the link below. All right, so here, let's remove this guy right here. And it's not happening. It doesn't want to come out. Come on, they're gonna come out of there. That's embarrassing. Do you have exactly the same problem there? Or not? That's the question. Maybe there's a sticker on the top that got soldered to, not soldered, but stuck to the... I don't want to break this plastic piece right here. Anyway, so I'll just let it be. Hopefully there are no screws under... Well, there should be screws here. Right, seriously, I mean, what's the problem? What's the holdup? You see what the problem is? Somebody didn't screw in the screw properly. What's that right there? This cable definitely not supposed to be like that. It's rubbing all over the casing, and it's not supposed to be here, it's supposed to be all the way in there. But my guess, they already replaced the CD-ROM before. Alright, so three screws right here. We got another screw right here. Alright. And I see that the board is separate right there. Which is a good thing. It'd be a lot less, a lot less. Alright, a lot less things to disassemble. Let's see. Alright, if this is not exactly the same laptop model as yours, you got 1000 plus videos on the channel of different laptops that we take apart. I wonder if this thing gonna come out together with that thing. Well, let me just in case remove it. I don't know, maybe, maybe not, but I'll just keep it here for right now. Let's see what we can do about this thing right here. Alright. Alrighty. That thing and that thing. I set that aside. And here we got this guy. Set that aside. And let's do this guy right there. All right, and we got four screws here. Two, three, so one, two, three, four, and five. Five screws. Something was supposed to be here, but obviously it's not there. All right, let's pry this whole thing out. You know what? I know where there's a hidden screw. Should be three of them right here. One. Two. And three right under the battery right here. Alright. Yeah, it's E550, it turns out. Alright, I didn't see that. It was kind of in blackish. Alright, so here's one problem that we see right here. You see this thing? It's rolling all over the motherboard, it shouldn't be here. Let's flip this guy over. See if anything else comes out. And we got another part came out, the metal part. Alright, so... Alright, and more stuff came out on the bottom. Alrighty, so now that everything came out the way it's supposed to be, we're gonna disconnect this thing. We're gonna remove that thing. And let's see if we can lift up this motherboard. Alright, there is a little ledge right there that holds the whole thing in place. So you wanna put the glasses on because all of that Chinese plastic gonna be flying all over the place. Okay, like that. Like that. Good job. All right, so we're gonna remove this jack from the motherboard. And the way I like to remove those guys, first of all, you wanna disconnect this guy right here. Because it's gonna melt and it's gonna sting pretty bad. As you can see, it's pretty damaged right here. The good thing, the positive not touching the negative, it would be touching. If it would be touching, it would be pretty much done. Alright, so we remove the top plastic piece. Because the top plastic piece is gonna be melting pretty badly. This piece right here, it's also gonna melt pretty badly. So I think I wanna remove it right now. Yeah, because once I put the hot air, because you see it's already cracked right there. Right here, if you can see it. So I'm just gonna crack it all the way out, because when it starts to stink, it's plastic. Melting plastic smell, nothing good comes out of it. All right so here, the more of that stuff you remove, the easier you're gonna breathe. You know, it's 2021, the lungs are really expensive nowadays. They started to go up in price in 2019, and now new lungs are ridiculously expensive. You're not gonna find them anywhere. So you don't want to be smelling the plastic. So here's the problem. You see this component right here. Alright, so this component right here, it's gonna fly off the motherboard for sure. Those guys right there, they're gonna fly off the motherboard as well. On the other side, nothing gonna fly off the motherboard. But this is the guy of my concern, and those two guys are my concern. So let's remove this garbage right here. And I finally found a Captain Tape dispenser, because it's been taking forever for me to find the edge of the tape. And now I can just do this like that. And like that. Wonderful. And I just want to make sure it's like that. Ooh. And you see how Chinese stuff works? Works really well. Well, it's not exactly... It wasn't really made for the Captain Tape. But I made it to work for me. All right, so good job. So what can I do here? What can I do? I'm gonna apply a whole bunch of flux all over this place and here and here. I'm gonna add new solder all over this place, here and here. And then I will try to desolder it using the hot air station. I'm also gonna add some flux right here, some solder here, and the whole thing is supposed to pop out. Let me show you how I'm gonna do that. Alrighty, so right here, I got too much brightness, but the new camera is coming soon. And I just added some flux. Let's add some solder to all of those connections here. All right. Like that. Like that, like that. And like that. All right, so the goal is to put more flux here and now run the hot air station. You know what? I want to put some tape on top of that plastic. It's pointless. I know that plastic gonna smell really bad, gonna melt really bad. So that's really toxic system to work on. And the board heats up pretty bad as well. But we'll try to. Uh-oh. I don't wanna touch the. Alrighty. I should remove this small nozzle from the hot air, but by the time I remove it, by the time I put a bigger nozzle or try to work it without the nozzle, it's just gonna take forever. So I'm just gonna work it like that. All right. And it's just getting too hot. Alright, you know what? This not working out for me. Alrighty, I understand this is not the best angle, but this is what I can do here. Alright. Should have put the smaller. Note, let's put some more air through. All right, just like that. Wonderful. All right, so we're gonna clean up the soldering, the solder from the board right here. Oh, let's remove that solder as well right here. All right, so everything is nicely Rind. Now it's possible to clean up every single hole right here and put the jack through. However, most of those aftermarket jacks, they come for some reason shorted. So even if you're gonna install it properly, the thing is there could be a short of some sort on this board right here, I mean on one of the connections, and the whole board gonna be shorting. So my goal is just to make the system work, and we're just gonna put the connector in here, and everything should be working fine. Alrighty, so we got a brand new jack right here. What I want to do is I want to remove the top right away and cut all of those pins on the top so that they're not going to be going through the motherboard. Alrighty, so I did remove all of the pins from the back of the jack. Now we're just going to make sure it's going to fit in there. Fits fine. Yep, let's flip it over like that, see if it's gonna be sitting. All right, so let's make sure it sits. I wish I would have a board holder of some sort here. And my wish came true, let's see. Let's see if we can mount this guy onto the board holder. Like that, wonderful. Good. I should have probably removed it on this board folder as well. Well, now what? All right, wonderful. Let's add some solder. Not the solder, the flux. Let's add some flux. And solder this guy from the top. Alrighty. The soldering iron is all in plastic from the old. Alrighty. Good job. Let's do. Alrighty, looks good. All right, here I need to add some flux. Here, right there, and right there. Little excess right here. All right, looks good. Make sure that this guy is all soldered up just fine. And let's clean this guy up. Some ISP to make sure it all penetrates nicely all over the place. All right, looks good. Looks wonderful. All righty. That's the final product right here. By the way, this thing you didn't need to take out. I was just over cautious. Let's put the small screw right there. Good job. All right. All right, so that screw goes right here. Let's connect the All right. This ledge should be keeping it downwards. All right. All right, wonderful. You see the problem? The hinge itself lifts up everything here. And that's pretty much the problem in this laptop. That's what makes the jack go bad. And another problem is there is nothing holding that hinge in place because this thing is broken off. So another one right there is broken too. You know what, let me just unscrew it to make sure that the board is tightly, the hinges are tightly in place. All right. You see, the plastic right here broke off. Right here. The hinges are extremely tight in here, and that's the reason why all of those issues happen. Ooh. Yeah, this guy is extremely tight. Ooh. Yeah. So this screw not holding anything here, really. I mean, it's just there for sure. Alright, but from my experience, let's see if we can make it slightly improved. What I'm doing here, I'm just trying to show you, is that I'm rotating this. Okay, much better. I'm rotating this nut right here that way. All right. So now this thing won't be lifting up the screen as much. Yes, it doesn't, it's not holding the screen in place as well in terms of, but it won't be lifting up this. Oh, you see right there, that's the problem right here. That's the problem. All right, that's not gonna work out for me. I need to fix it. And the way we fix it is the way how we fix anything else with magic. All right, where did that screw just went to? It was just here, okay, right there. All right, so let's unscrew this guy. And hopefully we're gonna be able to fix this guy up. So the goal was to make this guy as loose as possible. Alright. So it wouldn't be lifting this whole thing back and forth. And now what we're gonna do, we're gonna make sure that it's gonna be staying. This thing gonna be staying in there forever. Yeah, so let's do it. Alrighty, so the goal here. Ooh. That's not the goal. Hold on 1 second. It's all over my gloves now. Ay-yay-yay. Alright. So the goal here. Alright, something like that. Like that. And like that. And drop the hinge on top like that. Uh-oh. No, this is not working out. Nope. It's not working out. All right, let's try one more time. I'll try to secure this guy right there. Even though it doesn't want to get secured. All right, so here what we're gonna do is just pour this guy right there. Uh-oh. All right, so this is too close to the jack itself. And I have to hold it like that for a few minutes. Hold it down to make sure it's all pressed in and surrounded by the glue. I think I need to cut this guy out altogether. All right. Okay, so let's see if the top board gonna, if the board gonna fit in here. Glue is kind of hard already. Alrighty, so here what I wanna do, I wanna put a screw from the bottom and put it right here. And tighten it down right there. It's gonna take me some time, so just, and I don't have the right angle to show you how I'm gonna do that. All right, so extremely tightened up that screw and that nut through this hole so that it will hold the hinge in place, and you see it's not lifting up anything anymore right now. So I rotated all I want. Unless I rotate it all the way outwards, then the whole thing kind of lifts everything up. But right now everything should be peachy. Yeah. All right. So let's see if we can put this board in. And maybe I would like to add some hot glue there on the side as well. But I just want to be... I don't want to mess up this power button right here in any way, shape, or form. So let's see if we can just put this guy in. So yeah, the problem is not so much the jack on this model. The problem is the... Oh, the board doesn't want to get in there. Because you see right here, I put the nut through. So I guess I need to put the board, and then on top of the board, I need to put the nut. All right, so let me remove the nut and the screw from there. All right, so I removed the nut. Now this board's supposed to get in there just fine, without any problems whatsoever, I hope. Yep. Let's see. Yep. Plugs in there just fine. And we're gonna connect this guy right here. And I'm hoping to... Yeah, no, I mean, that's pretty much it for this repair. Because what I'm gonna do, I will try to... I'll try to put a screw right there through the board. Yep. All right, now, so the board holds the hinge and the nut holds the board and the hinge and everything else. And the power connection should be nice and solid from here on. Uh-oh. What's that? Okay. Is that the power button? It's not the power button. Why is it so hard to press? Maybe it overheated under the hot air. No, looks good. Should be fine. All right. Let's close down this No, that's not how it's supposed to be. Have to take it all apart. Something on the bottom just doesn't align fine with the jack. So I need to take it all apart and redo whatever I just did to everything here. Nothing is aligning there. Alright, so here I need to remove this glue I put on top of here. Because the jack is right underneath it. Easier said than done. The hot glue is already penetrated everything so well that it's kind of impossible to... Let's see, maybe we can just do... Go away with the screwdriver here. Nope, doesn't want to work. All right, let's see. Alrighty, so I just checked to, again, I put that screw right there, this screw right here. Excess glue was taken out. And right now, nothing is pinched. Everything is really the way how it should be. And you see when I move it up, down, up, down, up, down, this whole thing doesn't raise up and doesn't raise down. So this is all good right here. I like it. It's gonna work forever and ever for our clients. Yeah. So this laptop requires at least an hour and a half to get things done. So let's flip it over. Connect everything right here. Alrighty, so here we got the two connectors that we're gonna connect here. Again, the problem here is that hinge right there. That's the problem. And the hinge right here is also causing issues. I can see that. Let's see if we can just tighten those guys up. Up a bit tighter. Okay. So if you're sending us this board, make sure you're gonna figure out what's going on here, right? All right. Where is the cover? Cover is right here, and the problem with this cover, because we already have a nut right there, this nut right here, we have to remove this metal bracket because it's going to be on top of that nut and it's not going to hold anything. So let's cut this guy off. Alright, so we are going above and beyond the Call of Duty, but nobody ever really appreciates that. So the more I go above and beyond, the more people complain saying, oh, you know what? There is a screw. This thing no longer closes the way it was closing before. Well, it's hard to explain to the person that I did what should be done for the laptop, not what should be done cosmetically. If I wouldn't do what I just did, it would just stop working sometime pretty soon. All right, so which screws are going here? I wonder. All right, so I got five screws there. All right, let's do. Yeah, doesn't look like the right screw. No, they are correct screws, right? Never mind, those are long screws. I was thinking they should be of different. No, they fit fine everywhere. Wow. Never mind. Okay. Is that a screw right here? Oh, that's not a screw. Oh, that's a screw from the other side. Okay, never mind. So that should be fine. And that's a screw from another side. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I was thinking the fifth one gonna be there, but it's not. All right. So we connected the guy right here. Now we're gonna connect this guy right here. Like that, like that. And we're gonna connect this guy right there. Like that, like that. Now move it this way. Now move it backwards. Like that. Flip this guy over. And let's see if we're gonna be able to screw the keyboard in place. Alright, that's one screw. Here's another one for the keyboard. Alright, so that's the other one. Let's see, we got three screws that are supposed to go probably right here. Those are really short ones. So that's 1, 2, and this is 3. Right here. I wonder if there is a nut left in there. Okay. So there was a nut in there. How about here? Was there a nut here? And there is nothing there. How about here? Alright, so we got a nut right there. Let's see if we can screw down this guy right here as well. Alright, so we got three short screws going, one right here. Right, another one going in right there. And another one. By the way, if the video was useful, please leave a like. Subscribe, I will let you know which laptops I would never buy and which laptops are worth every penny. Alrighty, what next here? Strange, those are probably not that long. Oh, I know where this guy came from. This is from those side ones, never mind. Alright, how about next one here? Alrighty, so that's all the screws I got here. Let's see what else we got. All right, so let's put this guy in there and see if we're gonna be able to make the system work from that power supply, which doesn't even seem to be the right one. It has 2.25 amps. Alright, so the plug is definitely broken, as you can see right there, but this should be... It's not gonna damage the jack in any way, it's fine. I think, I hope. Let's plug it in. Alright. And I don't really see any lights anywhere. I'm not sure if it should give me the light or it shouldn't be giving me a light. Like a charge light someplace here. Maybe here. Strange. You know what, let me just double check to make sure that the cord is conducting the electricity. Here, let's take a look. Nope, there's nothing coming out of the power supply. All right, to fix the power supply, what we need to do is move this guy all the way out of here. Cut this guy like that. It seems like the original power supply to me. Oh, even, did I disconnect it from the power? Yeah, I disconnected from the power. I guess there was some current left in it and it started to burn. Okay, like that. Because it was smelling, I mean, it should be conducting the electricity here. Let's double check. Right. .5. That's exactly how it should be coming through. Alright, and let me go find a replacement cord and I will install the cord and power it up after these messages. I'm just kidding. Okay. Alrighty, so I put the new cord. I think that's the last cord I had here, so I have to order a few more of those. Let's see. Oh, forgot to power up the power supply on the other end. Let's see. Alright, we got 20.5. Alright, so the way how the repair gonna look like, you see there is a splice here and a new cable attached. So. Let's see. Oh yeah, I still don't see any lights anywhere, but I know that the power supply is supposed to be good. Maybe the brightness here is extreme. Oh, let's see. Oh, the power button here has a hard time being pressed in. Come on. Okay, we got the picture right there. All right, so I just want to make sure that the battery is charging. All right, so the battery is charging. Let me show you. Right there, you see it shows plugged in. And it charges. Alrighty. So the touchpad works. Alright, and let's see the keyboard. Come on, let's see if the keyboard gonna work. Alright, the keyboard is working. The wireless gonna be picking up soon. Wireless doesn't pick up anything. No, wireless does pick up everything. Okay, and then the sound, let's see if the sound gonna work. Come on, how do I test the sound so that... Alright, sound does work. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe, and you guys have a good day. Thanks.